Yeah?
I think you'd agree she's heading for serious trouble.
Oh, it's nothing that a good kick up the backside wouldn't fix.
Exactly. Our problem is finding someone to do it.
We need someone who can take what she dishes out without letting it get to them. Would you be willing to try?
Wait a minute. Are you asking me to knock that bloody great chip off her shoulder?
Maybe. Just cut it down to size.
You're joking! What happened to the old social work stuff? Let you down, has it?
Not exactly.
So much for the bleeding heart approach.
You think you could do better?
Maybe. If I had a free hand, I had to deal with plenty like her and the conquerors. But I'm no welfare worker. You'll have to find someone else.
I see.
It's a pity Nance isn't still around. She's the one you could use.
Well, it was just a thought. Back to the drawing board. Sorry.
What for? She's perfect.
But you heard
Koori
what
communities
said.
Have a lot in common with bikie gangs. Don't you see? Connor's methods are just what Sarah needs.
Please, Mr. Adams, I said I was sorry.
Get a move on, Joan.
You'll voodoo me.
Don't be stupid. She's only a bum. Back against the wall, West. Give her the tray, Jones. Come on, get moving.
Thank you.
Yeah. Stupid savage.
Take a break. Oh, right. Oh. Hey, guess what? Reno asked me to knock West into shape.
She doesn't have to ask. It's going to happen anyway, eh?
Yeah, she's not going to last the distance, that's for sure.
What'd you tell Reno?
Oh, what do you reckon? I'm not going to play wet nurse to anyone.
I need to talk to you. I'm in trouble.
So what's new?
The freak's trying to blackmail me.
Yeah?
What for?
If I tell you, will you promise to protect me?
I'm not promising nothing.
You know Mullins is going to try and kill
what's
me.
What's Mullins got to do?
Everything. You know that letter I sent out to her boyfriend?
Yeah, for a price, no doubt.
Yeah, well, my courier double-crossed me. Sold it to Gilmore.
You bitch! You let Lisa think it was her fault, you gutless...
I didn't know it was going to happen!
Jeez, the freak knows. Well, you're going to have to tell Mullins and take the consequences.
Yes. Having a friendly gossip, ladies. Oh, you can leave that stuff here and take it out after lunch.
Oh, no, you don't! We're all going to front Mullins, and you're going to tell her everything.
Working hard, Maxwell?
Oh, it's you.
Fortunately, but it could have been anyone.
Well, do you think it's big enough?
Yeah, I'll do for a start. But we won't have too much in there at any given time. It's too risky. Make sure they only get miniatures, too, enough to keep them sober.
Some grass?
Oh, yeah, a bit. And some pills. Keep them quiet, make life easier for me. But I draw the line at hard drugs, is that clear?
Perfectly. After all, you're the boss.
You're learning. Just remember, Maxwell, 70 customers out there and at $10 a week...
If we don't deal in the harder stuff, it leaves a corner of the market open for Simpson, the most lucrative corner.
Oh, don't worry about Simpson. I've had a chat with her.
And?
She's gone out of business.
My courier must have opened the letter and read it. Decided to make a buck.
Go on, all of it.
Your letter was sold to Gilmore. I didn't know, Lisa. I swear I didn't know. The freak must have found out. She's been trying to blackmail me. Otherwise, I would never have known, Lisa. I swear!
We're all glad you've got your voice back, Lisa, but I'm still a bit worried about you.
Why?
I believe you were talking to her when it happened. The police have established a direct link between Lester Marshall's death and the leaking of a message from this prison by you. That sort of revelation would be enough to stop Lisa feeling guilty.
Could be.
Then perhaps you'll be thinking of revenge.
I'm not a killer.
I hope not. I will not tolerate personal vendettas. If you'd given the police the information in the first place, your friend might still be alive. So you can't put all the blame on Simpson.
Is that all, Mrs. Reynolds?
For the moment. You needn't look so smug. If you're caught smuggling messages or anything else, in or out of Wentworth, I'll throw the book at you. Do you understand? That'll be all.
Come on.
I just came out of retirement.
What the blazes is going on?
Thanks, you can wait outside.
I'm supposed to stay.
It's all right, Mrs. Reynolds approved.
Listen, nothing doing. I told you before, I'm not playing fairy godmother to no kid.
No one's asking you to.
Oh, I suppose this is just a social call, isn't
it? In a manner of speaking, yes. So why don't you give me a chance?
All right, I'll listen. But I'm not promising nothing.
Fine. I've been looking through your file. You're very fond of your bikie gang, aren't you?
What's it to you?
I know the feeling.
Oh, how? Have you ever been in a club?
Not really, but something similar.
Oh, come on.
Back in the 60s, I got very involved with the Black Power movement. We're a small group with our own codes of behaviour and honour and our own rituals.
Yeah?
Our biggest thing was the freedom rides. We got hold of a bus. And we used to drive through all the small country towns in western New South Wales looking for cases of discrimination in pubs, pool halls, roadhouses, you name it.
Jeez, I bet you got into a few fights.
We sure did, especially the white guys in the group. Some redneck would say something about black velvet, and then it was on for young and old. Next thing, the cops were kicking us out of town. That only brought us closer together.
I know the feeling. How come you had whites with you?
It was the 60s. Everyone was the radical then. Rebels looking for a cause. We figured we needed the help. I was married to one for a while.
Yeah? What happened?
We busted up. It was tough. I went on a 2-month blind.
2 months?
All right. What do you want me to do?
Anyway, so I told Rena I wouldn't try and kill the bitch.
Jeez, well, I would if I were you.
Maybe. But I was partly to blame. I just want to forget the whole business.
Good idea. Come on, let's not talk about it anymore, eh?
Too bad Bloody Adams found out you got your voice back, though. I reckon you're onto a real good scam if you could turn it off when you felt like it, especially with the screws.
Red alert! Red alert! She's escaped!
Escaped? Who?
The Abbo! She's out of solitary!
Well, I told you not to call her that.
Well, then she's a...
She's not.
Did I do it right?
Perfect. What did she call her?
I'm not telling you because I know and you don't. I thought you knew all about it.
I'm not all about it. I mean, just a few words.
Hey, maybe there is a scam in this sign language stuff. Well, you could teach us how to do it. We could tell the officers to stuff it and we wouldn't cop a charge or anything.
Good idea.
Right. How do you say, I hope all your chooks turn into emus and kick your dunny door down?
Oh, there you go.
Oh, right, let's go and try it. Come on.
I like that. That's a good one.